straighten me out. Israel wants to bomb Iran within the next 9 months. It's a window. They don't call it a window of opportunity, but it's some sort of a window, which won't be open 9 months from now, according to Israel. I'm listening to a person from a think tank interviewed on Doug Fabrizio's show. And I guess what ticked me off is the use of the word existential. And she used it about 15 times in 1 minute, that Israel perceives Iran as an existential threat, and it must resort to an existential attack.
Okay.
So I'm just thinking, what's the difference between an existential threat, an existing threat, or just a plain threat? Just wondering. I never could get a handle on the word existential, and I've looked it up dozens of times over the course of my lifetime. But that's my problem. I understand that. Now the United States sees the window as being 15 months, and then the window or the door is going to close. But what we're talking about, what she's talking about on Doug Fabrizio is Radio West, is this, I don't know, I guess it's a strategic attack on Iran. And I'm thinking to myself, we're not going to get United Nations approval to attack Iran. You know Israel's not. Jesus Christ! The United Nations is what then? It's a joke. It's just there so that we can say we had to go into Libya because, well, we had to support our NATO pals and the United Nations resolution approved it. Jesus Christ. I don't know. It just makes me sick. That actually bombing the hell out of Iran, what's that going to do? That's going to unite the Shiites and the Sunnis. That's going to unite the Muslim world, especially if it's Israel, and the same thing if it's us. And what else? Right, the Saudis are going to clap their hands, I suppose. Not in front of the cameras, of course. But you know, what I'm getting at is that what is this all about? I mean, Iran gets a nuclear weapon. What does that mean? It means that Israel can no longer attack them, and the U.S. can't think of attacking them. Because they might just go berserk and launch a few nukes. Well, that's a deterrent. That doesn't pose a threat to Israel from being attacked by Iran. All it means is that Israel and the U.S. cannot no longer act with impunity by attacking Iran, which that's a sovereign country, isn't it? Now, I know they held all our people hostage there for a year. Was it more? I forget. But, they didn't like Jimmy Carter. But anyway, I don't know much about it. But yeah, for a time there, we hated those people. You know, you don't take Americans hostage without generating some feelings among the American people. But that was years ago. And put yourself in their shoes, in the Iranian shoes, that basically this is another way to look at it, that the U.S. is thinking of attacking and bombing the hell out of it, and Israel is thinking of attacking and bombing the hell out of it, because once they get a nuclear weapon, Israel cannot any longer think of attacking Iran. The U.S. can no longer think of attacking Iran. Put yourself in their shoes. Yeah, let's get that nuclear weapon, because we don't want to be attacked any more than the U.S. wants to be attacked or Israel wants to be attacked. It's supposed to be a deterrent. Hey, I just posted a deal there. Anyway, that's another story, but with Krista Tippett, we're talking about the, what do you call them, over there in Germany, about the time that the wall was coming down or before, diplomats who were juggling not metaphorically, they were moving nuclear weapons all over Europe. And she said these people, in her opinion, didn't have a whole lot of integrity. Unfortunately, I loved the guy when he ran, but I don't think Obama's got any more integrity than the rest of them. And they've all got their hand on the button. Jesus Christ. As if Iran getting a nuclear weapon is going to make any difference to us. Except that we can't bomb it with impunity.